First on BBC Two, a look at a man who achieved his ambition many years ago as a sporting gunsmith.
A gunsmith. Oh, mainly for repairing guns and renovating, cleaning. I also have a sports side to my business as well. I sell tennis rackets, hockey sticks, cricket bats, footballs, etc. Family business is over 100 years old now. It started in 1860 with my grandfather. Then my father was with him, the name of our Tilney and son. When grandfather died, I joined my father, Harry, and my father died at the last year of the war when I was in the Air Force. And now we've got Robert, and I hope Robert and I will carry on quite a long time with the same old business. Four generations, over 100 years. See, she doesn't eject quite so fast.
Yeah.
Well, now, I don't know what you think.
Well, mine does that. I mean, that's... I don't worry about.
You have a look at this.
My father, Lindsey Tilney, is 68 years old, and he and my mother, who's a school teacher, live at the back of the shop with my young brother, Robert. He's 18 and has just left school and started in the business. Lindsey is an all-round sportsman when he can get away from the shop, which really hasn't changed much since great-grandfather bought it in 1867.
It's absolutely stiff. Robert Tilney, gunmaker and dealer in game, near the White Lion Inn, Smallgate Street, Beccles, respectfully informs a gentleman sportsman and the public of Beccles and its vicinity that he has taken the business of the late Mr. John Easter and hopes by strict attention and reasonable charges to merit the patronage enjoyed by his late predecessor. Powder, shot, percussion caps, wadding, powder flask, shot pouches and alarm guns,
yep, and the dress
and every other article in the trade requisite for sportsmen. Sold agent for Prentice's gun cotton. And, all orders will be thankfully received and promptly executed.
DB. It's for Ron.
How about your left hammer, wasn't it?
I'm sorry?
It was your left, wasn't it?
Two barrels.
Yeah.
Yes, all right, lads.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Bye.
Thank you.
Cheerio. Yes, sir.
How much the guns?
How much?
The guns.
Well, have you got a certificate?
What's that?
Well, how old are you?
30.
Yeah. Well, you see, what you must do before you start talking about guns, you have to come in with your parents, okay? Come in then, and we'll have a talk it over, and he will have to get a gun certificate for you. All right? Yep.
Sure.
Righto, lad. Bring your dad or your elder brother in, okay?
Righto.
Cheerio, lad. I don't think he'll be very lucky somehow.
I'll bring mine as well. I'll do the same. And go over here. Right, Rob? Why don't you go to school?
I do teach a lot of the young boys clay pigeon shooting. I've had boys who've never shot a gun before, up to the experts who want to try and prove them what they're actually doing. The main thing about when you first go to a clay pigeon shoot, assuming you're getting on quite well, you always have your gun open.
never close, always open, okay? Yeah. And when you shut the gun and you put your cartridge in, you shut your stock up to the barrel. Good work. Well, look, we'll get a Roberts down in the where the clay is, and get him to throw a clay, and he'll both have a look at it, and then I'll have a shot. You can stand behind me, see what happens, and then you'll have about five and see how it goes. All right, Robert, pull. The place where it actually where you want to take it, but don't worry about that. I think in fact you'll find it'll come quite easy. You'll take it. So I'm not going to say anything to you either the first shot.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Well, we just try one. Just stand behind me, right behind me now, and I'll fire at this one. I hope I don't miss it, but it's quite on the cards. And you just, I'll show you what to do when we load, and as you will decide. All right. Okay. Right. Gun open. Cartridge in, touch your breech, gun is now safe. Bring it up to the ready position, and when you're ready, I'll shout pull for you. Okay?
Uh-huh.
Ready, Robert? Pull! Safe op, gun up, swing through, and kill it. All right? Sounds easy. I'll just do it once more. All yours. Okay, now this for goods. Cartridge in. Gun up. Into the ready position. Gun is at safe. Right. Pull! Safe off, gun up. Gun, break your gun. Now you're just a little bit behind it. Your gun. Now this time try and take it a bit further out. So I'll say pull, and then when you're on, get on as quickly as you can.
Yeah.
And I'll say fire when I think you're there. All right?
Okay.
Gun safe. Safe up. Pull. Gun up. Now. There you are. Well done. That's your first clay. A great point on these very good guns, or any gun, is to make sure you use a correct screwdriver to screw the screw home, or you're going to leave a burr on it, and that won't do. Put the gun together. That's the stop, barrels, fore and on. Yes. Try it with a pair of blank cartridges. Safety catch, just test it. Yeah, that's all right. Let's try them again. Another one done. What a beautiful gun that is. Wish I owned it myself. Notice the nice scroll work on here. All hand checkered. Everything that. These craftsmen are just not with us now. You never get the modern gunsmiths to do a job like that. They'll graze them on, but that's the one. Well, shooting, I suppose, is really my life, mainly rifle shooting. And I started from a very early age, I think at about 9. I got into the county team when I was 14. And I was picked to shoot for England in at Bisley. And that, of course, was the highlight of my career. The same year, it was a fantastic year, I think it was 1950, I also got into the final of the Queen's at Bisley and won the Suffolk Championship, both for small ball and for full ball, all in the same year. Needless to say, that was a red letter year.
Where are we going?
Well, then you're going to drive this wood through in the usual and I'll stand
ahead.
Up to
the pond.
With you, yeah, right.
Okay?
Yeah.
Or would you like to go ahead?
Well, I don't mind.
See Robert go ahead.
All right. You come in the wood with me.
Yeah. In the wood, yeah. I'll come around the left-hand side.
That's a good idea.
You go right and stand ahead of the wood. We'll drive it through to you, Rob. Now, I've been asked this question, why do I shoot things? And it's very, very difficult to give an answer. I think shooting, I've got to say, is in my blood. Perhaps that's a bad statement, but it is. But I've got enough confidence in myself to know that when I shoot, and I'm not being anything swanky in this way, that I feel that I kill and the thing doesn't know anything about it. That shall I say for the shooting. The main is, of course, it is skill. It's skill to kill a bird coming at you about 30 miles an hour. It's skill to shoot a running rabbit. So I suppose that comes into it. If I get an invitation from Sir Edmund Bacon, I'm just tickled pink, because I know it'll be a good sporting day, and I suppose I've got to admit that I look very much forward to it and enjoy it. I'm going to say that when you're driving pheasants from a wood and you've spaced out with the guns and you kill it cleanly and it falls dead, there's a tremendous amount of satisfaction. The bird is dead and doesn't know what happened. I know this is possibly an excuse for the purists, but it is one of the things. And I suppose the answer to that question is that I enjoy shooting very much.
I'd have been awfully done if Robert hadn't have come in, although possibly he would have made a jolly good school teacher. I don't think he'd have liked it, because he's very keen on shooting, very cute on fishing, and he's awfully very keen on guns. And I think he's going to make a first-class gunsmith. But apart from all that, he is already a first-class shot. In fact, the young blighter is actually beating me now.
Hold on, Robert, that was yours.
Mother had hinted at teaching, but it didn't really appeal to me because it didn't have enough variety. I have no great wish to attempt anything else. If it's connected with guns or with sport, that's fair enough with me, but my interests don't really go beyond that point.
When we shoot at Pakefield, which is rather a nice range, goes back to 500 yards.
That's a book.
We shoot mainly at 200 and occasionally 100 yards. And we get the police people down there. And the police are very keen on shooting now. They have been for quite a while. We've always had police teams in the county. And I, believe it or not, was a special constable, or rather a tiny one. And I think I was made that because I was captain of their rifle team. And we got a team from the Suffolk police, and we managed to get into the final of the Astor Cup, which is shot every year at Bisley.
Still up.
Nice to see you. I've gone to see what...
Most frequent customers are the farmer, who'll come in for cartridges or sports equipment, or just for a general moan. That quite frequently happens. Or even if you're selling him a box of 25 cartridges. It's not just the transaction. He also stops for a quarter of an hour and tell you he's being bothered by pigeons, or his pea crop isn't very good, or something of that nature. So it'll take you about a quarter of an hour just to get rid of one box of cartridges.
I shot a carrion crow that was giving him trouble the other day.
Ah. He's pleased to have that on back.
Absolutely, yeah.
I shot something a bit bigger than that, just beyond his place.
Did you?
Yeah,
a deer again?
No, Kessingland.
Not a deer?
No, it was a bullock, a mad bullock. They got it in the slaughterhouse, apparently, and it seems that the gun misfired. They knocked the chap down, escaped on the A12.
Did he?
Went into the fields at the back.
Yes.
And they rang me up, asked if I'd get over. Eventually, after, cut a long story short, we chased it down to the fields, and they drove it up to him in, it comes in 20 yards, and it stopped and got it right through the head. So that was that.
quite a successful finish.
What protection did you have, by the way?
Not any. I was a bit scared. Most people call it a rat. It's not a rat at all. The coypu is what is known as the neutra, and it was introduced into this country for its fur before the Second World War, and before we knew anything about it, Suffolk and Norfolk were literally full of coypu. They did a tremendous amount of damage to sugar beet, the banks on the side where the rushes are. I think I'm correct in saying I was one of the first people who's ever got one here. They have been a menace and have to be strictly controlled. A salient southhold is very good. You've got to be good there because the harbour is one of the trickiest harbours on the East Coast. Robert doesn't like it. I think it's my fault, possibly. I put him in the boat too young. He's seen me capsize once or twice, and I don't think he likes the idea of it. He might do one day, but we shall see. If Barbara's a star, she's a good crew. She sailed a lot in lots of boats. Barbara, no, you just can't keep her out of a boat. She's very good. She gets out on the trapeze very well indeed, and she is a good sailor.
The first time I went sailing was actually in a carricot, so I've sort of been sailing really for as long as I can remember, far longer than I've been walking, in fact, you know. But he's never actually taught me to sail, you know. I've never been taken out and said, well, this is how you do this. It's just a question of being with him and watching, really, and picking up like that. It was very nice when I was younger. I mean, we were always doing something. It's a bit off-putting, as I said, if you know you're never going to win. I mean, you can never beat him, but it's nice. I mean, he taught me to swim, to sail, to shoot, you know, the lot, so it's very nice.
We fish for trout at Kelso. It's a little place near Sexmundham. It's a private reservoir, and there's a small membership. We fish there about once a week, but we are allowed to take a guest, and of course that guest is obviously Robert, who fishes quite well as well, and we generally manage to get in one night's fishing a week. It's a lovely little place, possibly a little bit artificial, but the trout are quite difficult to catch and they give you quite good sport. The rainbow, no brown. Some quite nice fish there. The best fish I've had is 2 pounds 9 ounces, which is quite a nice one.
Say must be tedious. It's not too bad at all, actually. The great thing is to get your tension right, and that's done by pulling it up, and you work on a stringer which holds the tension one way, and you pull against it till you've come to the other way, and then the stringer will actually fall out, your tension's correct.
You lock that with a little awl like this. Bring it round. Another one there. Now your tension is crept that way. Start on the oil and bring it, start on the other one, bring your tension around here. Bring it round. Put the awl in there. Oh, that's the start. Once you've got that correct, it's going to be okay. Why you don't drop one of these or somebody comes in and knock it out, which I don't like. I used to play badminton quite a bit myself, but I'm getting a bit too old for that now. Still play quite a lot of tennis.
Sometimes, when I'm home for the weekend, we have a family game of tennis, and my married sister Marion joins in. Lindsey usually beats us. He's amazingly fit for his age. Lindsey and Robert spend most of their spare time together. All their interests are the same. There's always been a great rivalry between them, but Lindsey can still outshoot Robert.
He is in fact revoltingly athletic. I think he's kept himself in pretty good condition because he's always been doing something or other.
Athletics. Well, I've been very lucky with running. I've represented the county in the British Games 6 times, mainly for hurdling, long jumping and sprinting. I've played cricket, tennis and football for Beccles and for the county. I've been swimming all my life and taught swimming for several years at the schools. I'm graduated in Royal Life Saving and I'm now a grade 1 examiner. Although I don't swim quite so much at my age of 68. Old Beccles is a beautiful spot. As far as I'm concerned, he's got fishing, he's got swimming, he's got sailing, he's got shooting, right on your doorstep. And it's got the river which runs through the edge of the town, and our garden actually is on the edge of the river.
Well, I've lived here all my life, 68 years, and I don't want to leave it now.
If the fish bites, you got a good bait. Here's a little something I would like to relate. If the fish bites, you got good bait. I'm a going fishing, yes, I'm going fishing. I'm a going fishing too.
Why book Faye Presto? Because Faye Presto is not like other magicians.